Hello guys, welcome on in. A few little problems to start things off, but the draft has just about ended. We've got our first series of the day, Austria's Finest going up against EE's Disciples. Without further ado, let's see the end of the draft. There you go, five heroes picked for each team. My co-caster is also having issues. Today seems a little bit cursed on the tech front, but I've had some help. I've got someone actually sitting here waiting, making damn sure that everything's going to be fine, and it looks like we are good. I'm not sure. I'm a little bit loud there. I can turn myself down, but just minor things that we can sort out through the cast anyway. So Austria's Finest against Eternal Envy's Disciples. Two-game series in the joint Dota League European Division 2. And the draft has already ended. Gyrocopter, Tusk, Keeper of the Light, Ember Spirit, and Disruptor picked up for EED. While there's an Earthshaker Clockwork. That was their opening duo there from Austria's Finest. As well as... seconds remaining. PL, Storm, and Witch Doctor. I can hear in-game sounds, and I've not turned it on yet. I'm getting the eyebrows. Yeah, in-game sounds are coming through this, I guess. So I guess this does nothing. Oh well, that's fine. I can just turn that up a touch. So in-game sounds are coming through here. Oh, the gremlins have been to work. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. All right, we've got Dota TV audio. That's for sure. It's coming up. We've got audio going into the game. Yes, we can cheer and be happy about this. Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy, buddy, buddy. Okay, so in-game audio is coming through there. The mic is working. The mic is definitely working. I think I'm still a little bit too loud, but I can turn myself down again a tiny little bit. Oh! That's all the way up there. That should be better, I guess. And then we can... does that change anything? That doesn't change anything.
30 seconds to battle.
Yeah, that's definitely coming through there. Okay. Right. Is someone gonna die? That's the big question. Sorry about this, guys. We've been trying to fix a few little problems through the studios today. Right. I think my co-caster is ready. Let's see if this works. Let's see if this works. Drag and drop, are you there? Can I hear you? Can you hear me?
I can hear you, and I hope you can hear me, and I hope my PC doesn't decide that it wants to take another nap again, so...
Oh, excellent. Clockwork, though, not in such an excellent state, does back himself up behind the tier one. Ooh, what a day. What a day it has been. Yeah, yesterday I had some issues, and then we thought we fixed them all today, and then of course, you know, like three new problems just spring up out of nowhere. But
it was the exact same for me, actually. I was trying to cast a game yesterday for one of the Joint of the League matches as well, and then my PC started to have these weird graphical issues where that turns into a hitch for every couple of seconds for like half a second, and it's only... I can only fix that by a restart, and then it takes forever for my computer to load, but yeah.
Does nothing? Oh dear. Right, the stream is up, the stream's loaded, everything's running up there, but up at top, Cask with the Fisher, Teddy in a bit of trouble, and the Keeper of the Light will drop to the Phantom Lancer. Austria's Finest already off to a great start, the Tusk will be able to TP himself back to that tier 1 tower. Goodbye. Goodbye, Christian, the tech man.
Alright, that was a really good Fisher block by Half there. And yeah, I did some homework before, and I have seen a couple of Earthshakers played by Austria's Finest, so I'm not at all surprised that they're able to find these kind of things. A little bit of an interesting duo offlane as well here with the Keeper of the Light. We don't actually see that all that often. Would you say something different? I mean, not too familiar with EE's Disciples.
No, it's not something we see at all. Like, I think Team Secret tried to run it occasionally in their infancy. I can't remember what they ran with it. Maybe it was Zai plus Puppy, Keeper of the Light, and Tusk. Maybe that was something they did then. I definitely remember Puppy going for a Kotal dual offlane, and you know, he would go and sit in the trees and spam out these Illuminates to try and hold up that defensive tri-lane. I think the big thing here is it does make sure that both supports are actually static on this lane. The Witch Doctor and the ES both have to be here. They have to be trying to zone them out, control the lane, and defend that Phantom Lancer. So there's no actual aggressive movement from the Earthshaker towards mid. There's no fishers going towards this Ember Spirit and Pingvin check. Actually, let's look at the lanes. Pingvin check is the Ember Spirit at mid up against Nova Storm Spirit. Nova has recently transitioned. Oh, they're gone again. The out fisher. Maui in a ton of trouble. Illuminate. He does come across and he snowballed himself up with the shards, looking for maybe a counter kill here, but Chair Raider with half, they'll find that kill once again. But yeah, Nova has switched recently from like the five roll support to their mid lane. I'm not sure if that's something they do every once in a while or if that's now a permanent kind of role for him. But Chair Radio Witch Doctor smoking up with half on the Earthshaker. And now they've got that kill, they feel a little bit safer giving Killer this solo top lane as the Phantom Lancer. Teddy and Maui, we've already seen their Tusk and Cottle, but now Pingvin Check has gone aggressive here onto Nova, trying to get the burn in, but with a Fissure block, Cask to follow, not in range, not in range. They get the hit out, and with the Cask, they'll find it. No miss uphill from Nova. And down at bottom lane, Clockwork does get taken out there by a glimpse into Rocket Barrage. Action abound across all three lanes, pretty much.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Hello? I think I've lost my co-caster. Skype is saying there's a problem. Oh, dearie, dearie me. What a day. What a day. Hello, everybody. Hopefully you're having a better day than we are here in the studio. But Austria's finest, they're off to a grand old start. EED do have some decent solid laning setups here, though. McGraw on your gyrocopter down at bottom. He is Radiant side, so if he does decide, he can farm up all three of these camps at the same time, pull them across, and call down on top. Nova mid, Pingvin check, does throw out the Searing Chains to slow that aggression. And with PQMZ now placing a ward up on the high ground, level 2 glimpse. Looking to actually find a kill here onto the Storm Spread, but up at top lane, there's already Death and Destruction. Keeper of the Light has dropped. Chair Raider and Killer both getting pretty low on HP, but Nova glimpse back. Irie, the Clockwork's here. He's got the cogs. He's got the battery assault as well, probably. I can't click on him. No, he doesn't. Level 2 in the rocket. That's a little more standard. Well, back to mid we go. Nova up against this Ember Spirit. Spirit on Spirit action there.
I'm glad there's a lot of action here because, well, kind of paints over the fact that I still have issues here and can't really contribute too much just yet.
Is it our side or is it your side?
It was my side again, I think. Just got one of these major hitches again, and it actually threw me out of Dota. So, but doesn't look like it's persistent this time.
Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed.
Yeah, absolutely.
Almost had the tech guy running back up here to try and sort it out. Oh man. Okay.
Hey, maybe you can send it over to my place. That would help. Well, a little bit too far away, I guess, though.
Time to focus on the game. Oh, there we go. You've reconnected. Ember Spirit just found a solo kill on that Storm Sprint. Great little pick off him. Chair Raider has moved in to try and help out. Oh my goodness. 5 minutes and I've not had the last hits little table up. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. Right.
Oh, well, it happens with everything else going on. But yeah, that solo kill from the Ember Spirit is actually very important. Actually, there's another kill going the other way. Maybe another
got no mana.
Block, but do they have enough damage? There's a cast coming in, and another ball lightning here, another one here. Nova just having enough mana to actually make that work inside the trees there.
Yeah, he had no mana for a spirit out, so no escape mechanism there from the Ember. And the movement from these supports has been pretty good. PQMZ could look for the glimpse back onto Chair Raider. Not gonna throw it out there, though. A little bit worried about who's behind him. And the kills they've got up on top lane. You know, I was saying how they're kind of forced to be in a static position up at top to try and defend against this Cottle and Tusk. The Witch Doctor and Earthshaker have actually managed to move themselves around, open up the mid lane a bit for Nova, who's, you know, 0-1 and 2, but his item progression is going to get up and running pretty quickly, especially when the Earthshaker's stacking camps. And bot lane, Clockwork. A tiny bit of trouble there, running through the trees. There is no glimpse. It has already been used, but McGraw just going to flat cannon through these creeps. Mid, Nova in trouble once again. Stick charges and ball lightning away. Pingvin check, double remnant forward, but misses the mark. As Nova sidesteps and runs himself back and now maybe looks to turn and fight. He ball lightnings up. There's still this flame guard up with level 2 Searing Chains. Turn around, possible here from the Ember. But in the end, it's going to be have to throw out that final fissure and have the last say in things.
Just doesn't stop in his middle lane, does it?
No.
I'm pretty sure Blitz or someone else could probably tell you more about this matchup, especially since there's a Storm Spirit involved, but of course it's breaking up a little bit now. It's just since the Ember Spirit got a lot of levels and now
Ember
it's looking for
has
revenge
got the Searing Chains and Flame God Hef. Good Fisher, not going to block him out though. Pingvin check doesn't have any second tier boots. He's not going to be able to chase through there, and the nice little bottle exchange onto the Earthshaker will give him just enough, yeah, just over for that Fisher cost. And you'll take a look at this Ember. Flame Guard is about to run out. And he's got no mana left for Searing Chains or a Remnant. Or at least he can throw a Remnant. He can't jump back to it.
Well, he'll probably teleport back to base in a second, refill his bottle, and then come back to the Remnants. Once he has enough mana right now. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, this is actually the point where the Ember Spirit gets really, really dangerous, because he's got his levels here, seven, or almost level 8, 7.5 minutes in. And these supports, they live on a nice edge here. Half, of course, can protect himself a little bit further between the stuns that he has. Witch Doctor, though, if he gets caught out, or even the Storm Spirit here, if he's caught out with a little bit too little mana, and if Penguin Check doesn't actually misses the Spirit Jump, then that can lead to some extra kills. And yeah, Storm Spirit, sure, he doesn't even have a point into the Electric Vortex yet, so he can't protect himself that way, and his magic damage will be blocked by the Flame Guard, so he has to be very careful here.
Oh man, look at Nova. Cancel animation on that Ball Lightning just to make sure that there's no go from Penguin Check, who jumps back to his own Remnant. Down at bot rune, maybe a little go here. Clockwork has his bottle, so he's picking up these runes while Ember, fissured up. Storm makes damn sure he gets that haste up at top. And we did see a good exchange up at top lane, actually, from the Tuscan Keeper of the Light. They dropped Killer low, but this Phantom Lancer with a doppelganger, with the fact he can dodge out of Illuminate, not going to get it this time, and now he's in trouble. This is where he's overstepped his bounds and going to get taken out. Storm has come in, though. No Vortex. He's got the damage, takes out the Tusk, and maybe just about kills off the Keeper of the Light as well.
That was a really, really good rotation. Of course, sucks a little bit that Phantom Lancer got caught off there. A little bit missing the timing there. I think they wanted to have Nova run in just as the Phantom Lancer was ready to start fighting, but they didn't really count on the aggression coming out from the Tusk as well as the Keeper of the Light.
Well, yeah, he's dodged a couple of Illuminates and things like that, but this time, not getting that timing just right. They are stacking up a ton of camps, though. Look at the Storm Spirit. Triple stack over here with, what's going on? Witch Doctor down and out. Penguin Check, fissured now. With PQMZ coming in from the side, Ball Lightning's ready from the Storm Sprint, and he will jump forward, Searing Chains and Glimpse. Can he get the damage out? Yes, he can. As the Maledict will finally tick him over.
Yeah, Revenge from the Grave there, and that's just such a strong spell. Really underrated by some teams, but he's actually focusing some extra points into it, not actually maxing out the Wood Restoration. And this kind of game, with that much action that we're seeing, bottom lane again, a little bit of an exchange. But yeah, it's definitely the right choice here. Just maxing out the cast, get that value points into the Restoration in case you want to do some pushes and need looking for some sustain. Or then I'll just go for the Maledict.
Yeah, you've got so much damage output that you can actually lay down onto someone before the Maledict starts ticking. Remnants, Lancers, Fissures, and even this level 3 Rocket Flare, you know, that does a hefty amount of damage. 160 at level 3, which is up to now. Lyrie has hit his 6, and this is the benchmark for hook shots flying out like we're going to see here. McGraw, that DD rune you wanted. Well, what about that? Rocket Barrage is what up? Clockwork down, and Charade are on the run as well. It's Witch Doctor.
He can run, though. He doesn't have another cask here. Nothing
he
to bounce,
be okay.
Even if he did. But the tower is still standing there, and the Malediction, of course, Gyrocopter doesn't really want to take extra damage from that.
Oh, poor little Clockwork.
Yeah, well, hitting hook shots is great and all, but if you're hooking into a Gyrocopter, then that's exactly what's going to happen. It's going to turn on Rocket Brush, and at this point, Clockwork is nowhere near tanky enough to withstand that, and can't even reflect the damage because he doesn't have late melee yet, obviously.
Yeah, exactly. And that's where you see like the power spikes of these heroes. Clockwork is great, sort of level 1, level 2 kind of thing, when you're just like cog spamming, burning mana, and making sure life's a living hell. Now, though, this is where McGraw on this Gyrocopter, he's hitting his power spike. He knows 4 in Barrage, 1 in that cooldown, and Tier 1 Tower is going to be their objective that they're eyeing up right now. Phantom Lancer up at top kills off the Tusk, while middle lane, Teddy on his Cottle. Be very thankful that Storm Spirit only has 300 mana. Oh, you're a dead one as well.
Yeah, and right now it looks like a free Tier 1 down here for EE's Disciples here. At the same time, the Killer is pushing quite heftily at the top, but they should be able to respond to that if they want to. But then again, they might run into Chair Raider, who has an early aggressive Observer Ward here on this hill. Don't actually see that this early in the game, mostly. Maybe we see a ward here to just look for the same kind of rotations, though. So nothing wrong with that if they want to secure this tower. And it looks like that's what they want to do here.
Yeah, and very commonly around this time, when you've taken down this Tier 1, I wouldn't be surprised to see Charade place his second Observer Ward, you know, a little bit deeper here. He's going to go for the Sneaky Ward there, okay. But, like, this timing is often when you want to see a ward watching out for these jungle camps over on the west side. I heard Searing Chains. He's farming jungle camps. But yeah, on the western jungle camps, for things like this, when the gyrocopter goes and clears camps out, when they've got stacks up and things like that, having an observer ward in this general area, maybe even between the tier 1 and tier 2, just looking for that transition. But they are focusing a lot of emphasis on mid and top. They know Phantom Lancer is going to be split pushing away for the next 5 minutes or so, get his defusal blade, and then maybe start to draw the fights in. But it's not going to be a fight. There's going to be a pickoff here onto the Tusk. He's got a snowball to try and dodge out a few projectiles. Maybe a bit of damage here. Maui salving up inside the snowball. It's already been cancelled off, actually, as the cooldown does drop. Nova's got no mana. Storm Spirit caught out off guard. And now in comes the cavalry. Chair Raider nearly died. Did he get glimpsed? No, he's fine. But Hef, definitely not.
Yeah, it was a really good idea from AF to go for that play since they just got that ward down. So they, well, they thought they had all the intel. But then they run into the Tusk instead of the Keeper of the Light, who was the only one they were really expecting there, because, well, what's a team with a Cuddle gonna do if you put pressure on a lane? Well, they're gonna send the Cuddle there, spam out with the Illuminate, so they expected him to be there, want to get a quick pick off into a tower, but instead they ran into Tusk, and there was enough time for Gyrocopter to come in and do that great counter-attack here with the cooldown that only he is really capable of providing you.
Yeah, exactly. Especially this early on. He's only got Treads and Dominator, and that might be his weakness right here. Hookshot not on the mark as Nova zips zapping back and forth, dodges out the Static Storm, but he's not going to get a kill just yet. Finally finishes off that Gyrocopter, but Pingvacek is on the hunt, looking for more. Finds the Clockwork. He's going to have to remnant himself away to safety as PQMZ, a Disruptor, throwing his spells left and right, but not really getting a good grasp on that team fight. Nova just, you know, outstripping him every step.
PQMZ almost dying to the Rocket Player there, left with below 50 health points, so he decided to teleport back instead. But yeah, that was another one of these exchanges. I mean, normally if that's not a Gyrocopter, then you'd lose one or maybe two heroes without being able to get any count kill, and like that they do get the exchange onto Nova, and I think the Witch Doctor as well. And Chair Raider had a really good cast there too. It's not like that was a bad engagement for AF, it's just the power of the Gyrocopter really showing itself right now in these kind of situations, 50 minutes in. And it's gonna maybe take until 20 minutes until that starts being a little bit less effective.
Yeah, now they've broken even on kills, but I've got to say, their supports are doing exceptionally well on the net worth front. This Keeper of the Light, 3.9, now up to 4k gold, Illuminate spam galore. And he's actually not far away from his Aghanims, you know, 1700 at 14 minutes until he has that big old shiny staff, and that's when things get a little bit scary. Healing Illuminate during the daytime, that unobstructed flying vision as well all around him in a sphere of lovely light for that Keeper. But now Hookshot with a Fissure to follow, PQMZ. He's got a glimpse in the kinetic field. The cooldown will land onto the Clockwork, but Disruptor still hasn't died. Now the remnants come through from Kid Pink. Check, he fights both of them with the Searing Chains. Four are dead, and Nova can't even find a kill on the Keeper. Disruptor's the only one to drop here as the slow onto the remnant. The Ember Spirit is trying to run over the cliff, but the overload damage and charge do make sure that he is stopped in his tracks. But holy crap, Austria's finest. They keep running into these fights where it's like, we've got a decent amount of damage here, we've got some good lockdown, but they just can't chain up their skills correctly.
Yeah, they thought they had enough, but barely not enough to kill the Disruptor before he can get his Static Storm off, and that was such a huge Static Storm. It's really hard to just find the right words for it, because that gave them four kills just like that. And AF committed a lot. I think they committed a hookshot onto him, they even committed the Echo Slam. But
yeah, they fissured, yeah, and then hookshotted at pretty much the same time, so there was a lot of overlap with the stuns there. And then in the end, it was like, well, we've got to get this kill now. We've committed so far. We've got to Echo Slam. Nova is out of mana, but there's no glimpse or anything here from the Disruptor. Still on cooldown for 5 seconds time.
PQMZ is the master of survival here, it looks like. It's the third time I see him at that low kind of health, and still AF not really able to finish him off. So that means he's actually also rather rich for Disruptor at this point in the game. I mean, it's not a hero that farms particularly well, unless he gets a load of assists, and that's exactly what we have right here. Even two kills to his name is... How did that happen? Ember Spirit, okay, never mind.
I think Witch Doctor was trying to ward somewhere. Maybe try and get a ward in this area to watch for movement from the tier 1 up into the Dire Jungle. And yeah, Ember Spirit, who I was going to bring up, basically has Battle Fury. You know, he's 700 gold away from it. 17 minutes in.
For movement, that's what he did. Not with the ward, but with himself, unfortunately.
So. He tanked the gank, I think, is what we call it nowadays. Made sure that the PL didn't die, but Ember Spirit against PL has been touted as, you know, the hero to deal with Broodmother, Phantom Lancer, all these illusion, nasty little annoying heroes. And if he gets such a fast Battle Fury, he's got the treads build up as well. Treads, Aquila, PMS Bottle. It's not just, I've got Battle Fury and nothing else like an Anti-Mage kind of does. He has the build up to actually make it work. So his farming rate, he's going to go through the roof. He's going to dominate this Phantom Lancer who, does he have Diffusal? I know he stopped off for that Morbid Mask. Yeah, he's got it now. So he completes that up. But it's the support, Earthshaker and Witch Doctor. I've seen Austria's Finest do this combo before, and they've excelled when they get ahead, and they start, you know, racking up kill after kill after kill. Chair Raider gets a fast Aghanim's, and a quick old Blink Dagger onto Hef. But at this stage, you're still looking... Like, they're doing okay. They're going to have sort of standard-ish timings, like average timings, you know, 25, 30, 35 minutes for the Blink, and then for the Aghanim's kind of deal, but... Is it going to be enough? Especially when your Storm is going for an Orchid over the Bloodstone.
I think they needed Orchid, though. I mean, if you look at the Ember Spirit with that high of a net worth, you kind of have to have something against that. And right now, what do you have? You have a lot of short duration stuns from the Clockwork, from the Earthshaker, unless he gets a full combo off on top of you. But he doesn't have a Blink Dagger yet, so it's kind of hard up against an Ember Spirit. So without perfect lockdown, they're not going to be able to kill that guy. But as we just said, Emerswood, with that kind of net worth, he can kill you if you just give him a little bit of room.
Oh, yeah. Right?
So they need something, some solid silence here from the Orchid to actually lock him down long enough to be able to kill him, or at least make him not want to join the fight. So they can at least have some space for the Phantom Lancer to start some work.
They found the PL. The Ember Spirit did at least, but it runs out of mana very quickly. Battle Fury has now been delivered. They've got a juicy old Ancient Stack over here as well. I was just looking at that Courier, and my goodness, there's an Aghanim's done for the Keeper of the Light now. he's done it! Pre-20 minute Aghanim Scepter up on him. The Tusk has suffered a little bit, you know, Treads Bracer, there's no Glimmer Cape, no Blink, nothing along those lines. But the big question is, are they not going to build a mech? Oh, well, Tusk drops a bot. Nova, TP out. Should be okay here. No, the Blinding Light with the Mana Drain combo. Teddy comes in and finds the kill. Well, Ember Spirit's going 1v3. They've got a hookshot, but they're not going to throw it. Remnant back will keep him alive.
Well, yeah, without the silence there, I mean, Storm Spirit's still reasonably close to the Orchid, so it didn't actually put him back all that far. But yeah, without the Orchid, it's just really hard to just chain stun the Ember Spirit so they can actually kill him. So, better hold on to the hookshot here, find a target that's actually more killable.
But who's that gonna be? 1300 HP over McGraw with Agi Treads. He's got 17 plus 8 armor. 25 freaking armor. And when you look at Austria's Finest, what have they got? Physical damage from the PL. Physical damage from, you know, the Storm Spirit. You know, okay, he's got Remnants and Ball Lightning, but a ton of his actual damage output is from right clicks and pumping this out. Overload is still magical, though. Witch Doctor Death Ward, physical damage. It's going to be a rough old time actually killing off this Gyro. Then he's got Lifesteal on top of this, and you can only assume next item is going to be that S and Y done. That's going to tank him up even more.
It's actually a good question for Clockwork. Who does he really go on? It's not like there's an easy target in this game. I mean, there's a Disruptor who can glimpse him back.
Yep.
There's a Keeper of the Light who has his Aghanim Scepter, so he always has a Blinding Light to push the Clockwork out. Ember Spirit, well, don't have to talk about him, he's just a Psu Remnant.
Tuska Snowball.
Tuska Snowball, yeah, Gyrocopter has the Rocket Barrage, so you don't really want to go on him either. Because he can turn around so easily. Sure, you might be able to kill him with a little bit of help. But yeah, with that S and Y on in the works and his further item progression, especially with the teammates behind him, it's not easy either. So.
Oh, well, they've got the turnaround here onto Tusk. Hookshot misses, and now in comes the cooldown. They're going to catch a bunch of heroes here. McGraw goes straight in onto the Earthshaker. Death Ward tickling away at the Gyrocopter as Nova is trapped in the Static Storm. No mana left, no life left as he's taken out by the Rocket Barrage. Two drop. Tusk does lose his life for that, and Killer now trying to hold back the hordes. As Eternal Envy's Disciples, McGraw just decides, well, I'm going to flat cannon down the Witch Doctor, who's trying to run away in the back, clips onto the PL, and down they all drop like flies. Clockwork is the last man standing. But I'm not sure what he's standing for.
You know what Tusk is saying right now?
Worth.
Hashtag space created.
Or that, yep.
There is so much space created in the figurative sense, also in the literative sense, as the tower does go down. Four kills on the board, and yeah, just once again, that really good turnaround potential. With the Static Storm, immaculate play from the Disruptor there. I just want to give BQMZ another shout out. Static Storm was great, catches the storms, but they make sure that they drain all the rest of his mana with their Blinding Light even. And then a glimpse back on the real Phantom Lancer as well. Netted them another kill, so it's just the thing with Disruptor, you can't really fight if he has a Static Storm up. You can't run away from him either.
Yeah, it's very difficult. EED have great chasing power, they've got great turnaround strength as well in these team fights, and you can see Austria's Finest, they want to try and find a sneaky little pick here on the Gyro. They've got Orchid, they've got the slow, Ball Lightning forward, there's the Silence onto McGraw, Nova, along with a Fissure. They're doing damage to him, but is it going to be critical damage? He turns and fights, and Nova's the one that's going to die! Oh, I saw that turning around right before my eyes, and it was painful. Nova, 50 seconds without him, and Chair Raider, you're invis, you're stuck here. You're in a bit of trouble, but you should be able to TP yourself back to your fountain, but maybe Earthshaker is not going to have that luxury. Slight of Fist, Searing Chains at the ready, Pingvin check. I think Hef is just waiting here, and he knows it. No need to use the chains until the last second. Don't give him the chance to TP away.
Yep. That was just really sad to watch for the Stormsword. I mean, normally, with Stormsword being so popular these days, you're used to seeing Stormsword like zipping around, getting kills left, right, and center. But that Gyrocopter with the S and Y and the drums and the treads and everything he has got going on, it looked like McGraw didn't even mind him at all. It's
no.
Just like a little flyer that just zips around him, literally. And yeah, once the Silence ended, you just use the spells, and yeah, that's Stormsword right there.
What is the, like, you know, the team flag? Not the flag, but the kind of banner in the ground, whatever it's called, the logo of Austria's Finest. Is that a schnitzel?
That's a schnitzel. Okay. Schnitzel with some citrus.
With some lemon. Next question, what is on the flag? Looks like some kind of cake or a pancake or something, I don't know.
On AF's flag?
Yeah.
It's the color of the Austrian flag. That's those colors.
Oh, no, I don't mean that flag in the top bar. I mean, actually, on like the banners.
Those banners. It looks like Kaiserschmarrn, maybe?
Okay, I don't know what that is.
It's quite nice.
King's bread.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
I can't really explain it.
It's something edible. They like their food.
It's something edible, yes, and it's quite tasty as well.
Okay.
Sort of like pancakes, you could say.
Okay. They look like pancakes. I'm just going to call them pancakes. Gyro has an eagle song, so that butterfly is not far away. And I was talking about his survivability against this physical damage. It's going to get even stronger. With Maui now having a Blink Dagger, able to save people through with that Tusk Snowball. Crit up on your Ember Spirit with another 2400 gold to boot. And this Keeper of the Light, he's got an Ultimate Orb. You know, just chilling. Teddy, Cottle. Building into what, a hex or something like that?
The Keeper of the Light has 200 less net worth than the Phantom Lancer.
Oh yeah, that's normal, you know?
Yeah.
He's 1,000 net worth ahead of the Storm, that's... You see that every day.
I played Cottle Carry once, it was fun. My team just left me solo in the safe lane for some reason.
Oh yeah, Desolator, AC, Shadowblade.
Yeah, something like that.
That's the way to go. Or you go for the E-Blade Dagon build, of course, but that's standard for everybody.
Yeah.
Now...
It's too boring.
Yeah. Net worth wise, what are you looking at? It started off great for AF. You know, they had, what, a 1,000, maybe 1,500 net worth lead for a good 10 minutes or so. You know, they held that lead steady. They made sure that they were slightly ahead. Then all of a sudden, the switch up started. EED up to 15,000 net worth ahead of AF right now in terms of experience and gold. With Nova AT. I don't know if he was going for a Roche Steel. He was looking for someone on the side to try and pick off, but he's not going to get anything there. Rocket Flare will scout out the Roche. It's a little bit slow here. There's no Medallion, nothing really helping the speed of this. And Phantom Lancer heads himself over to the Secret Shop, buys a Reaver, but this is time that you could be spending split pushing a little bit wasted. Hef is building up into that Blink Dagger up on the top lane, so they've given him a little bit of time. While Witch Doctor, okay, that's pretty decent. He's now 800 gold away from his Aghanim Scepter and very close to level 11.
Yeah, I feel like if AF can drag the game out a little bit longer, then they can still take these kind of team fights. Just because if the Earthshaker gets his Blink, and if the Witch Doctor gets his Aghanim set, those are going to be the crucial items for me, I think. Because Phantom Lancer, he can still do a decent amount of damage by himself with the Diffusal Blade just because of the mana burn. He just needs to have the space in the fights to get the illusions going and not get focused down, so...
Space and chaining stuns and things like that, sure, great. But Nova has been caught here, zips over, dead, he's gone. 60 seconds until he's back up, unless he wants to spend that buyback. But yeah, like, chaining stuns, execution, getting everything right in these team fights and creating space for the PL, that's all nice and dandy, but... If you don't have the time to do that, when McGraw has Aegis of the Immortal, he's pushing your tier 3, there's a DD on your Ember Spirit, you don't have these items up.
From the Cottle as well.
Yeah.
So this daytime.
During that daytime, it's pretty nasty. Glimpse back. No, not going to find it. Not going
to
get a pickoff.
They're too afraid to actually start going onto him, and I can definitely understand that. I mean, they can throw out the Lancers here, but even with the Reaver up and running, it's not going to be tanky enough to even bother them all that much. And yeah,
like you
just using that Aegis very well.
Yeah, you definitely can't go in when there's a DD on the Ember Spirit. Like, that's for sure. Chair Raid is pretty much out of mana. There's no Death Ward. Maui gets Echo Slammed, but here come the crits. Down to go with a cooldown. Finishes off the Witch Doctor and Storm. He's about to respawn. Your melee racks have gone. Ranged racks still standing. McGraw just going to hammer away at that. Clockwork. He's been seen. Pingvin check. He wants him. The Ember Spirit, they're spam pinging like, dudes, let's go for more. You're going to get healed up by the Illuminate. Back up to full, pretty much. As daytime comes to a close and switches to night.
As hard as it seems right now for AEF, I don't really think they can save any part of the base at this point. I mean, they use their Echo Slam to no avail, and yeah, exactly. They know it too, they call the GG right now.
Pretty clean win there, pretty clean overall win. So Eternal Envy's Disciples take game number one in that two-game series. And that honestly started well for Austria's Finest. They had the great top lane where they pretty much crushed the Tusk and the Keeper of the Light. They moved mid, they helped out the Storm. But it was just the little things. The Gyrocopter got his farm up and running, and then the sudden switch up in pace. When the Ember Spirit started jumping around, finding solo kills on a Storm, Disruptor, I think, had a great role in that game as well, glimpsing people back at exactly the right time to find the openings on the kills.
Yeah, it feels like AF just didn't have enough time for the Phantom Lancer to get online. I mean, if you draft a Storm Spirit, if you draft a Clockwork, these are the kind of heroes that you want to be able to create that space with Nova getting shut down in mid, not really getting much beyond the Orchid, and then Clockwork, of course, not having the easiest game up against this lineup from EE's Disciples. Yeah, it's just not working out for AF in this instance.
Yeah, well, we'll be back in a couple of minutes, guys, with game number two of this two-game series. I'm Durka, joining me Drag and Drop. Don't go anywhere.